And in aspiring India, parents' top priority is to send their children to school. But what are they learning there? Well, according to the latest education report, not much. 25% of class 8 students can't read a class 2 text. Simple maths, subtraction and division is a huge challenge for many. Ketki Angre reports.
This should have been child's play, but is proving to be a Herculean task for school children in rural India. The 2014 annual status of education report for rural India shows that 25% class 8 students still cannot read simple texts meant for class 2 students. Roughly only 60% could explain meanings of the words they had read. Again, almost a quarter of class 4 students can't do these basic two-digit subtractions. Worse, the number of children in class 2 who cannot recognize numbers up to 9 has jumped from 11% in 2009 to almost 20% in 2014.
In the case of math, however, we see a continued decline. I think that there is a curriculum, there is textbooks, and there are things that children ought to learn if they are moving at age grade level. But if you have large numbers of children who are not at that level, then we need to rethink our priorities and start where the kid children are.
In fact, taking a cue from previous such surveys, states like Bihar, Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra are adopting new techniques to focus on learning deficiencies so that students who lag behind can be brought on par with others.
There is a silver lining though. For the sixth year in a row, school enrollment has been at 96%. School infrastructure too has seen an improvement. Schools complying with the right to education, teacher and pupil ratio has nearly touched the 50% mark. A jump from 45.3% last year. Drinking water facilities are available in 75.6 schools, up from 72.7 in 2010. Usable toilets have gone up by over 10% since 2010, and usable toilets for girls have gone up by over 20% in the same period. But the trend of rural students moving away from government schools to private ones continues, with 30% of all rural students now in private schools. Though the survey also shows there isn't any significant difference in the learning. From the Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan of 2004, aimed at universalization of elementary education, the time has come to ensure that those who enroll not only stay in school, but also benefit from it. In New Delhi, Ketki Angre for NDTV.